Of course, mom Marianne Fox was in court as well today, and yesterday in a statement, she revealed first on K2 that Grant suffers from a rare mental illness called PANDAS.
K2 problem solver Shelley Bailey Shaw is here with more on this condition. And Shelley, the illness is believed to be the result of a very common illness.
Right. It actually starts as a reoccurring strep infection, sometimes undiagnosed. In some kids, the body gets confused and then attacks itself in the brain. As was the case with Marianne Fox, parents find it difficult to get their children diagnosed and then treated.
And then she did call me on Sunday after her son had been arrested.
Marianne Fox first reached out to Beth Maloney in the fall of 2011 after reading her book, Saving Sammy. The book chronicles her son's struggle with PANDAS. Maloney found she wasn't alone.
I've received over 20,000 emails, and I have received emails from families, including another family in Portland, Oregon, where it wasn't really until they eradicated strep everywhere, including the family dog, that their child recovered.
That's right. Doctors at Dornbecker Children's Hospital say the infection can be carried through humans and animals.
What we'll see is people who are functioning pretty well, who suddenly have a dramatic deterioration, become obsessed or concerned about a very specific and unusual idea or thought or behavior.
The symptoms? Obsessive compulsive behaviors, mood swings, irritability, separation anxiety, and decreased abilities in math and handwriting. According to Maloney, Grant's mom said the antibiotics to treat PANDAS weren't working. She was trying to switch insurance to get him covered for a very costly intravenous treatment.
This is a really serious disorder. And the reluctance among so many in the medical community to recognize the fact that an infection can cause mental illness is frustrating.
Now, only a handful of doctors in our area have experience treating PANDAS. To prevent it, doctors say you need to stop the reoccurrence of strep in the first place. That means the child and other family members need to complete a full course of antibiotics.
So you get PANDAS, can you be cured?
You know, according to Maloney, yes, her son actually took very high doses of a particular antibiotic for 5 years, and today he is cured, but that treatment doesn't work for everybody.
Fascinating stuff. Thank you very much, Shelley.
If you want to learn more about the condition PANDAS, we have additional information on our website. Go to k2.com. Inside K2 tab, click on the hot links.